While they were incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it and ate it in front of them. He said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In his final encyclical on the Eucharist, just before his death, St. John Paul II asked the entire Church to seek to rediscover the great mystery of the Holy Eucharist. He said that he wanted to enkindle Eucharistic amazement once more in the Church. How can we explain the mystery of the real presence of Jesus in the Eucharist? I think ultimately it leads us to one word, love. Jesus is here because he loves us much more than we could ever imagine. We all know that the more we love someone, the more we want to be with that person. This is why it can be so sad when we come into churches and see, in a certain respect, Jesus the most neglected. His real presence in the tabernacle, and there's no fuss and there's no interest sometimes to this great gift. You know, when we are separated from our loved ones, there's a great pain, and when we're reunited again, there's a great joy when we're together again. And this explains a little bit of the real presence of Jesus in the Holy Eucharist. He loves us so much that he never wants to leave us. He says, "Know that I am with you always." Because wherever your treasure is, there your heart will be too. We are his treasure. And he will never leave us. And he remains here with a heart burning with love for us in the Blessed Sacrament. God our Father's desire for each of us is that we will find true happiness. When we think of happiness, we don't know what to think of sometimes, and we don't know where to look. But true happiness comes when we encounter his Son, truly encounter his Son in the Holy Eucharist. Because true happiness comes from finding true love. And that is the gift of the Eucharist. It is the gift of Jesus, this love that never changes, this love that has no limits, this love that is always there night and day. And it is this love that waits for each of us personally in the Blessed Sacrament. We know that Holy Mass on Sunday is the high point of our prayer. And Eucharistic adoration is a very natural continuation of our communal prayer at Mass. And since Christ remains always present in our churches day and night, he merits our loving presence with him always, day and night. And it is for this reason that the Church has asked every parish to establish continual or perpetual Eucharistic adoration. And you do have a most beautiful adoration chapel here. What a wonderful gift to have Jesus being made available for each soul of the parish, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And we need more people to sign up, and that is one of the purposes of this mission, to invite each and every one of you, if you don't have a holy hour, to sign up and commit to 1 hour of adoration during the week. If we think about it, we take an hour for Mass and an hour for adoration. We still have 166 hours left in the week. So Jesus never asks too much of us, bearing in mind that he gave us all of the hours to begin with. And so if all of us sign up for a holy hour of adoration, we can truly have an unbroken chain of love and adoration offered back from this parish to the wonderful heart of Jesus. I'm sure many of you are familiar with the revelation of the Sacred Heart of Jesus to St. Margaret Mary Alacoque back in the 17th century. And in that vision, Jesus lays bare his heart. He lays it bare. And we know when we choose to love, we choose to become vulnerable in a certain respect, because maybe our love will not be returned. Maybe it won't be appreciated. Maybe it'll even be trampled underfoot. And that's the truth of Jesus when he lays his heart bare. And he says to St. Margaret Mary, "Behold this heart which has loved humanity so much that it has spared nothing, to the point of exhausting and consuming itself to show them its love. And I receive from most of humanity nothing but ingratitude, irreverence, sacrilege, coldness, and scorn." Then he said, "I have a burning thirst to be honored and loved by all in the Holy Sacrament. And I find nearly no one who strives according to my desire to quench my thirst by loving me in return." The vulnerability of Christ when he comes in Holy Communion into a human heart. Will his love be appreciated? Will it be neglected, rejected? Will it be scorned? And this is the way Christ offers himself continually in every sacred host to every human heart that comes to receive him. Jesus implores us to love him in the Blessed Sacrament. He said that he literally thirsts for our loving presence with him in the Blessed Sacrament. Then he went on to tell St. Margaret Mary that when we believe in his love and return him love for love, then he will take up his reign, and we will see the miraculous power of his Sacred Heart. So when we encounter the Eucharist, we encounter a person who thirsts for our love. Jesus once said to St. Faustina, the Polish sister who received the Divine Mercy revelation, that often in the Eucharist, we treat him as a thing, an object, and not a person. She saw Jesus in a vision, and in this vision he looked sad, and when she asked him why, he said, "When I come to a human heart in Holy Communion, my hands are full of all kinds of graces which I want to give to the soul, which I want to give to the soul. But souls do not even pay attention to me. They leave me to myself. They busy themselves with other things. They treat me as a dead object. They do not recognize love." So when Christ comes to us in Holy Communion, we must welcome him as a living person, talk to him and listen to him, and give thanks for this wonderful gift of Christ now within us. And we can continue this dialogue of love and adoration all week long in Eucharistic adoration. Sometimes people think a holy hour is not as difficult to do. They think a whole hour to spend before the Blessed Sacrament perhaps is too long. They never think that way about a movie or a ball game or any kind of pleasure or entertainment. It is a question of what do you really actually put first? Who do you put first? Who will you love most? If we don't love him most of all, above and beyond all these other things that take up place in our hearts, we need a healing. And please don't live like that. Jesus first, always Jesus first. And no one and nothing deserves the pride of place and that wonderful, if you like, chamber that he has reserved for himself in every human heart. That is his rightful residence. And when we think, even for a moment, a holy hour and adoration is not difficult to do. Because Jesus truly is the easiest person in the world to encounter. As St. Mother Teresa used to say about adoration, nowhere are you more loved or more welcome than here. And the most beautiful moments we spend in this life are the ones we spend in the presence of the Blessed Sacrament. Sometimes people wonder how to pray in adoration, and there's so many ways to pray. Perhaps meditate on the Gospels, the words that Christ shared with his first followers, to meditate on them and to hear Christ saying them to us, his followers of today, in the presence of the same Jesus of Nazareth, we can share in the gift of the first apostles. Or maybe you want to pray the rosary, to take the hand of Our Lady, and she is the surest way into the heart of Jesus. Or you may want to take Jesus at his word when he said to each and every one of us, I call you friend. And to really have him and choose to hold him as your best and dearest friend. And those moments in their lives that are difficult or trialsome or burdensome, to come and share them with the greatest friend we could ever possibly have. Because he's always there. He's always available. He's always willing to listen. And most especially, he has all of the remedies in his loving heart. And so that is the most beautiful way to pray, to come and share our hearts with Christ. He said to St. Faustina, the smallest movement in your heart, I am deeply interested in it. Scripture reminds us of the importance of praying during the night. And I want you to bear this in mind as you sign up for a holy hour, to really consider the nighttime hours. Jesus often spent the whole night in prayer, especially before important moments in his life. And the first hour he asked of his followers was a holy hour during the night when he said, when he looked for a friend, and he said, could you not watch 1 hour with me? That cry of Jesus goes forth from the sacred host to each and every follower, inviting us, gesturing to us to come and spend that 1 hour with him. The Catechism tells us that the church and the world have great need of Eucharistic worship. And all of the needs that we can see can be remedied by the act of Eucharistic worship, because he, and only he, can make all things new. And he is so there for the asking. As hatred once lifted Christ up onto the cross, So now may our sacrifice of adoration lift him up in love and draw down upon ourselves, our families, and indeed the whole human race, the graces he won for us in Mount Calvary. And now I invite the ushers to begin handing out the invitation cards. And if you have a look at the invitation cards, they're very simple to fill out. And I do ask that you fill them out right away because they will be collected immediately after Holy Communion in this Mass. And as you can see, there's pencils in your pews. You can pass them along. The invitation cards are very simple. All we really need is your name and contact information. If you have any questions or reservations, you can discuss those over the phone. And believe me, any reservation you may have is very easily answered. One common one I hear is, if I sign up for Tuesday at 7 p.m. and I can't come next Tuesday, what happens? We do have people that step in those situations. So really everything is very well covered. I invite you men especially to step up for the nighttime hours. As a little loving sacrifice, perhaps for your family, to lead your family in prayer. Sometimes children especially need to see the man leading in the role of prayer. And just to speak a little bit about the gift of nighttime adoration. When we wake up to come to pray during the night, there's something very special. All of the distractions and the nuisances of the day have not even begun. Our interior is silent and still. And when we come in the quiet of the night to be with the Lord in adoration, we are so very well disposed and able to quickly encounter the living God. It is a wonderful, wonderful time to pray. And if you sign up for the nighttime hours, and most people I'm sure would concur on this, you will have more energy and more vitality for the day ahead. It's one of the miracles, if you like, of Eucharistic adoration. There's also the common miracle. Sometimes people think, you know, I don't have time for a holy hour. We don't have time not to adore the Lord. Life is too short. And if we make time for a holy hour, we find ourselves with far more time to accomplish the tasks, and they're easier to accomplish when we do this and we make this sacrifice for the Lord. So please begin filling out your invitation cards right away, because they will be collected right after Holy Communion. Thank you for your attention. Let us stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us then and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. Forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As we continue to rejoice in the resurrection of Jesus, let us bring our needs to God in prayer.
For the church, that its words and actions may reflect Jesus' teaching in his love and concern and forgiveness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in the many places throughout the world where there's war, and for open hearts to aid nations where there's hunger, poverty, and disease, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those oppressed, afflicted, or in need, that societies marginalized may be known and defended by Christians as God's own work, God's own, worthy of dignity and respect. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the parishioners of Christ the King, that we be beacons of love in our society. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in our diocese who are in formation for the diaconate, priesthood, or religious life, that God richly bless them as they continue to discern their vocation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our Covenant Church, Christ Church Cathedral in Lexington, and our sister parishes, Holy Trinity Church in Harland and Christ the King Church in Asasan, Ghana. May their communities be blessed. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray also for the repose of the souls of all who have died. In a particular way, we pray for Father Tom Carroll, for John Shropshire, for Colette Eertz, and for today's Mass intention of Dan McHale Sr., for the repose of their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, draw us to Christ, your Son, and guide us always along the paths of hope, justice, and love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My love.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant Church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Amen.
fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep at the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
If the ushers can collect the invitation cards. Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen. It's truly been a joy to have Father Declan with us today. He'll also be here through Monday and Tuesday, and we'll have, as was mentioned earlier, we'll have our diocesan Eucharistic mission Monday evening and Tuesday evening. We'll have adoration. Father Declan will give a Eucharistic reflection, and we'll also have confessions available. So those will begin at 6:30 p.m., so I warmly invite you to not only come, but also invite others to come as well. We also still have a few of our Easter flowers that were here for Easter, so please feel free to take those home. We would rather that they go home with you rather than stay here and go in our dumpster, so please do take those. And we also have Jesus also desires to pour out his love upon us in abundance, and our prayer ministry teams will be available after Mass. We'll have teams available both near the St. Mary altar and the St. Joseph altar over here if you would like to avail yourself of that prayer ministry. And finally, we also have a night's breakfast going on over in the hall. So please stop by and enjoy.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.